When we first defined our tables, we defined the relationship between them in terms of constraints. Now we are going to implement that relationship into our query using a join. This join will allow us to query the weather table for values from a specific location setting. We'll start by adding an SQLite Query Builder class variable at the top of Weather Provider. We'll initialize the SQLite Query Builder in the static constructor for the class, describing the join between both tables. Note, since both tables have a column named underscore ID, we must explicitly use the table name in order to disambiguate which underscore ID we are talking about in the join. Then we can define the query. The query is defined using the question mark replacement syntax. These question marks will be replaced by the query parameters. Since we allow people to specify the start date in the URI, we're also going to add a second selection, which includes checking to see whether date text is greater than or equal to our parameter. Next, we'll add a method to get the weather by location entry using the same query builder. Note that we fetch the parameters from our URI and build a string array so they can be substituted into our query. Note that if a URI does not contain a start date, we actually use a different selection. Finally, we add the function into the query routine of our content provider.